So my friends, today we have discussed about the correlation in agriculture, not in other field. Okay, let's we go on the sheet of correlation. Already I have fed up their data. I will show you and what type of formula is used there to calculate the correlation coefficient and test the statistic. Okay, you can see here the I have three softwares or three methods that I will tell you in a simple way how to correlation do in Excel, how to correlation do in SPSS. Those persons having SPSS, they can do also their very simple way the correlation. Then also in Excel format, there is in a manually or also correlation given in a data analysis. Okay, how it's activated, that I will show you. Now you can see here the my Excel sheet. Now here the statistics 7, this is not required for us. Okay, this is a software SPSS. Then okay, just I go correlation sheet. Okay, now you are able to see this sheet. Okay, I minimize this channel. Okay, now you see this is a clear format. Okay, before going to the calculation or before going to the analysis of the correlation, before that we want to learn different terms related to correlation. Okay, what mean by the correlation? Correlation is the relationship or degree of relationship between dependent variable with association of variable, means associated variables, means the degree of relationship between dependent variable and independent variable. Okay, this is the given the degree. Okay, now second terms is a Pearson correlation. There is a three types of correlation. Okay, we can the calculate the Pearson correlation, and then we can use the scatter diagram for the calculation of correlation. Then we can use the Spearman's correlation coefficient. Okay, now we can use here only the Pearson correlation. Pearson correlation means when the data is a quantitative data, then we can use the Pearson correlation coefficient. But when the data is qualitative, means honesty, beauty, the type of data is there, then we can use the Spearman's rank correlation coefficient. There is a rank is must for given to each observation. Okay, now most important part in correlation is correlation, means the it is positive correlation. Positive correlation means, for example, we can see here the aphid per plant, then correlated factor is maximum temperature. Okay, now this is positively correlated. Now you see when aphid population increases with the increasing in a temperature, called as positive correlation, or aphid population is decreases with the decrease in a temperature or in a maximum temperature, called as a positive correlation. Then we can see the negative correlation means one variable or dependent variable is grow or increase opposite direction to independent variable, called as a negative correlation. Means when aphid population is increases, the maximum temperature is decreases, or when aphid population is decreases, maximum temperature is increases. That things is happen in a negative correlation. Now we can next see here the zero or no correlation. Means in aphid bird plant or in maximum temperature, there is no any relationship or any degree of relationship is not found there. Means when temperature changes, there will be no effect or effect on the aphids per plant. There is a no correlation or zero correlation. In that, now most important part which is required for the significance is a degree of freedom. Degree of freedom means number of observation minus 1 when it is used in design of experiment, DOE. In that we can use that, but in correlation degrees of freedom minus 2 means n minus 2 means 19 means here is 26 meteorology, MW means meteorological week. Okay, 26 to 43 means 21 observation is there. Now 21 minus 2 is 90. This is a degree of freedom. Okay, then you can see the correlation lies between. I bold it, it will be visible for you. Okay, you see the correlation lies between plus 1 to minus 1. Okay, you see the correlation lies between plus 1 to minus 1. You can see here the value is nearly equal to the plus 1. You can see there the positive correlation. When values comes in plus or positive, it will be the positive correlation. Or values comes in a negative sign, that will be the negative correlation. Then values come 0, there will be the no correlation. Okay. Next, we want to see the how its value are highly correlated, moderately correlated, or small correlated. Okay, when value is less than 0.300, okay, you can see here positive value. When positive value is near to or lower than 0.300, it will be the small correlation between two variables, as well as same like in negative sign also. When the negative 0.300 or below that values, it will be the negative correlation or small negative correlation between. When the value is in positive things, 300 to 500, it means it will be the moderate correlation between two variables, same like in negative sign also. In next, values above the 600, it will be the highly positive correlation, or in negative sign also or negative correlation also, they are the highly values, means three values we have seen. Okay, next I'm going to for calculation. Okay, first we want to learn the correlation. Okay, now you can do also manually, same like you use is equal to correlation, means coral formula is inside the Excel. You put there array first and array second. Array first means what? Then our population means what? Aphid population. Okay, comma. Array second means which variable we want to correlate, maximum temperature. You can select that array means total number of observation in that particular variable. Okay, then after close the bracket and press the enter, you see here the correlation. Okay, 0.417, it is moderately positive correlation. We have seen that moderately how it comes. Now we can see the next correlation of another factor. Give here sign is equal to and select correlation and select first array, which is the dependent variable. Give comma, select second, minimum temperature, and close bracket, enter. Okay, it comes in negative sign, 4.468, means it is moderately negative correlated. Okay, same like that, this is the one method. Then I cut it, I show you, this is the correlation formula, correl formula. Okay, we see this same value is in Pearson formula, Pearson. Okay, now give is equal to sign, put the Pearson. Okay, you see here the Pearson, select it array means dependent variable, then comma, second array, independent variable. Okay, close bracket, enter. Okay, now you can see here the difference. Pearson's also same value and Corel formula also is same value. There is no variation. Okay, I can autofillate, not come well. Okay, now this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, only the 6 variable. This is another simple formula we can use for each and every variable or calculate the correlation coefficient. Okay, may you understand these formulas? It is very simple. Now you may be seeing this or not, I show you. Okay, now you see clearly this. You see the here is the different marks or different titles is given. You see here the XLSTAT. This is the another software I have downloaded. Okay, I show you that also give the very nice result. Okay, that software is not regularly nobody can use. Okay, so we can calculate the correlation in our Excel. How it's go to data, when going to data you see here the data analysis, but this option is not is here. Okay, we want to add it from add-ins. How add it? Okay, I show you. You go to file, go to option, then you can see here the dialog box is open. You now see the general information, formulas, proofing, save, language, advanced, customized, driven, quick access toolbar, add-ins. We want to go in add-ins. Okay, now here the add-ins is open. Okay, now you see here active applications add-ins or inactive application add-ins. Okay, this is inactive application. I am not activated because I doesn't want this application right now. That's why I am not activated this application. You can activate this application. You can see here the Acrobat PDF, Office add-in, and then analysis tool pack adding or in Excel stat star. Okay, for the addition, you see here the manage Excel add-ins. You click on go. Okay, now this dialog box is open. Now you can see here the checkbox. Here is number of checkbox. You can browse also the options from your computer, or automation self is here. You can only click the automations. Number of options is there. You select it and add in this list. Now I am adding Excel stat and analysis toolpack. Okay, and check this toolpack and okay. Now you come directly to the data and see here the option data analysis. Okay, there is no problem. You go open the data analysis. Okay, now you see here the analysis of ANOVA single factor, ANOVA two factor with the replications, ANOVA two factor without replication, then correlation, covariance, then descriptive statistics, then exponential some things, then F test, then histogram, then regression, then random number generation, rank and percentile, then T test, pair two sample for means, then T test two sample assuming equal variance, then T test two sample assuming unequal variance, and J test. There is a number of things given in that. Okay, we select the correlation. We want the correlation. Okay, now here one dialog box is open. You can see here. Here first is the input, then input range. What mean by the input range? Input range means dependent variable plus independent variable. That is the input range. Okay. For example, our independent variable is maximum temperature, minimum temperature, then relative humidity, sunshine and rain, and our dependent variable aphid per plant. Okay, we can select titles also, aphid per plant to rain and whole data. Okay, this is the range, input range. Then label in first row. Okay, you click it. You go to label for first row. You keep as it is columns. Okay, now you can hear the output option. See here the output option. First is the output range. You check it. Then click on that box and select the output range. And select this cell for the output range. Is G36. Okay, now I hear okay. Okay, now you can see here the aphid per plant, maximum temperature. This is the correlation matrix. Okay, right here correlation matrix. Okay, only this values in matrix is come. Okay, now we only focus on this values, which is important for us. I make it red, type it. You can see the now he see here the maximum temperature 0.4173. okay, same like last time value for the correlation and pairs. Okay, now I delete these things which is repeated or not required for us. Okay, I cut it and paste here. This is the correlation matrix. This only the correlation is come. Now we want to obtain the result for the 5% or 1%. Now I am not going to the 1%, I am going to the 5% only. Okay, you can see here the only this value is the R values. Okay, simple R values. Now test statistic. Test statistics. Okay. In correlation, we can use the t-test, not a f-test. F-test is used for the DOE. DOE means design of experiment. Okay. Now, this is for 5%. Okay. T-test calculated or t-calculated only. Calculated. Okay, how you can calculate it? Okay, we doesn't require this data for IFA. Okay, you can see first value is positively correlated, second value is negatively correlated with IFA's, then third value is positively correlated, fourth value is negatively correlated, and sunshine is positively correlated and rain negatively correlated. Means rain increases, IFA decreases. You see the negative. Okay, before that we see that the what mean by the positive, negative and zero correlation. Okay, that's why I am not explain again. Okay, t calculated and t table. Okay, and significance. Okay, now we see only these things. So maybe you are not seeing these things. That's why I repeat it. Okay, I bold it. An increase in size. You may, it's visible. Okay, t calculator. How you calculate t? You want to know, or you must know the formula for the calculation of the t test or t calculated. Okay, you put here the is equal to. Now we want to convert this values in positive things, because we are not used this values in negative things. First, that was the way we want to do what? Okay, come back and here absolute value. You know the absolute value, which formula is used? You see here I am using this is equal to. You see in this formula bar, or you see directly here A, B, S. You put only the ABS and double click on the ABS number. Here ABS means absolute number. Absolute means when we give the input of the positive number and close the bracket and put enter, it gives the actual number. Means it's positive number. But when we give the negative number to the absolute number formula, it gives a positive number. Okay, you can see here it's given the positive values. Okay, now I am coming to the t calculate value. You put here the is equal to. This is a manual method. Okay, this thing's correlation matrix is obtained from the data analysis. With that option is available in data format, and how it's activated, that's I shown you. That's why I am not repeat again it. Okay, now round also is used, but we doesn't want that things in round. So you can select directly, go to the home button. Okay, now this formula is running, that's why it's not working. Okay, now select it and reduce the number. You see the decrease in decimal. Okay, 3 decimal. It is sufficient for the calculation purpose. Okay, now you can see the is equal to for t calculated is equal to. I'm showing only the one variable is here, not in all variables. You can do same things, it will be give you a better result. Okay. Now formula is t calculated is equal to n minus 2, means that degrees of freedom is equal to r. Values are r values where I put here r means r values means this value. Okay, we want to take here the absolute value, not any minus and all that side. Okay, R values, then give to R values, then give to the bracket for that. Okay, second, divided by square root, square root R square or 1 minus square root of 1 minus R square, 1 minus R square bracket complete and another bracket complete, main bracket means two bracket is here, first bracket for this under bracket and outer bracket for this. Okay, there afterward into square root of n minus 2 means 19 or square root of 21 minus 2, bracket complete or enter. Okay, you can see here the value is 2.000. This is a t calculated value. Okay, I show you this is a t table value. How it comes table value? Okay, here is a directly formula, not go to search table where I kept that table and that things is not here. Okay, you think each and everything is available in Excel. Okay, I go to here is equal to 10. Now this is a t test, this is not a test, that's why the t and I and v. Okay, you see here the notification, this formula is available for compatibility with Excel 2007 and earlier, returns the 210 inverse of the student t distribution. Means this formula is not working in Excel 2007, but now we are using Excel 2010 or 2016 or latest update. That way we don't have that problem. Okay, I use this. Okay, they're asking me the probability, means how many probability you can choose at your own, means 99% confidence or 95% confidence. I choose 95% confidence, means 0.05, then give the comma, then degrees of freedom. How many degrees of freedom? 21 minus 2 is 19 degrees of freedom, and close bracket, press enter. Okay, you can see here the this is 2.093. okay, make it 3 digits. Okay, it will be nice for understanding. Okay, now we want to see the significance. Now here is the most important. You see here is equal to formula for the significance is equal to if t calculated value or t table value, t calculated value is greater than or equal, greater than or equal, t calculated value or greater than or equal to t table value, it shows significant or equal, it shows significant comma, double inverted comma, before that double inverted comma, completed, then give comma, then give double inverted comma, give non significant, then Q double inverted comma for completion this and complete bracket enter. Okay, you can see here the non-significant when this value is increases to this value, it can show the significance. It is less as compared to this value for all the things. Okay, I show you this how it's obtained significance. When this significance for the 0.05% alpha level. Okay, you can also put here symbol alpha level or directly p is equal to 0.05 also you write here, no problem. This is all meaning is same. Okay, now you maybe understand what these things or whatever things in correlation. It is simple. This is a correlation, not more than that. This is a manual method for the calculation of correlation. Okay, now I have software of the XL stat. I show you what is the inference obtained by our method and what is the inference obtained by Excel static that I will show you. Okay, let's say save it. Now I am going to the Excel stat. Now here is the start button. I start it. Okay, you can also give here the star, one star for 0.05% alpha level. If significant, then give two star at 99% confidence levels, means 0.01 alpha level if significant. Okay, this is a license or something. Okay, this you can see here the number of things is seen to you. Here is the correlation association and visualization data, preparation of data, then describing data, then analysis of data. Here the factor analysis, principal analysis, number of things is given here. Then modeling of data. Here is the MANOVA, ANOVA, ANOVA. Then linear regression, non-linear regression, cubic spleen, then parameter test, different test is given here, then non-parameter test also given here, then advanced feature in advanced sensory data analysis, then conjoint analysis, then power analysis, then statistical process control, then DOE, okay, design of experiment. I taught about this earlier. Then survival analysis, then method validation is very important, then dose effect analysis, then omics analysis, data analysis, it is used for the botany. Okay, this is a number of things, or PLC path modeling or path analysis, a number of things is given. In that I select the correlation association, in that correlation test. Okay, you see here the one dialog box is open. Now same like this is in SPSS software. I'm not going to show this SPSS software because the time is too long. That's why I'm not going for the SPSS software. Okay, you can see here the correlation, then general observation. Observation means quantitative variables, not a qualitative. You can select the aphid, sunshine, rain in full range. Okay, then no weight, no substitution. You see here the type of correlation, which type of correlation we want to obtain, that we can select from this button. Okay, here the Pearson correlation, Spearman correlation, and the Kendall correlation, and in polychloric correlation we want to obtain the Pearson correlation. Okay, then second here is the range means where obtain that data. Okay, IQ to that range is here. is the correlation ratio. Okay, no problem. I give this range. Then here is a tick box or check box variable label, because we select the variable labels also, that's why you tick here. Then you see here the significance level percentage. How many significance? You can put here 1 or 5. I am putting here 5 because I am doing work on 5 in agriculture only, not in other fields. Now general, okay, I completed this task. Then missing data. Do not accept missing data. It is very important. Then any missing thing, don't accept it. Then output. What coming with our hand? Okay. I am not only descriptive statistic, which is not required for us. Then correlation, that required for us. Then p-values, that also required for us for the significant of correlation in bold values. Okay, that I also required. These things is given here. Then charts. But now this is scatter plot charts. Then matrix of plot charts. Different types of charts, regression line, color by correlation, and correlation max, and different things is, or number of things is given here. But I am not going to this. I am only going to the scatter plot, or I show you the scatter method also there. Okay. Now I am going to the okay. Now here is a given list of selection. You can see here the selection name, observation criteria 21, then column 7 column, then range 0, row and column 1. Okay, now I continue it. Okay, now you can see here. It is very simple or fantastic software. Give the answer of your question within 2 or 5 seconds, so not more than that. Okay, you see here the starting time 55:35 and at end time 55:37. Only 2 seconds is required for the calculation of the Pearson correlation coefficient with significance at a 5% alpha level. This is very simple. It gives all things is here, and types of correlation, test and type and worksheet and summary, and also range given. Okay, the summary of statistic means quantitative data, not a qualitative data. It is given the 21 observation for each variable, then with missing, 0 missing. When here is the missing observation, they may not be accept. Then without missing, 21 observation remaining, minimum, then maximum number, then mean, standard deviation. These things is given here. Okay, most important thing is the correlation matrix. Okay, these things we want to put or paste in our thesis. How it looks in thesis, that I will show you afterward. Okay, you can see only this is a matrix format, that's why the it's shown the number of things or number of values. You can see here the maximum temperature with acid 0.417. okay, this you can see here also in our hand method, 0.4173. you can see also here the significant, non-significant, and you see here the non-significant means this is a bold value or this is a without bold value. Bold value is significance, or those value are not bold, that values are non-significant. You can see here the value in bold are difference from the 0 with the significance level alpha 0.05, means 95 confidence. Okay, this is a negatively significant, negatively correlated significant values. Okay, in our thesis we want to use this table only, not other things. I am not going to these things because this is not usable for us. Okay, you go to the home and go to the bottom border and go to the all border. Okay, you may be the all border for these things. Now you delete these things because this is matrix. Now you see here the 1 1 1 1 1 is common for all, or this value you can see here this value is put up in this. Okay, same like okay, another value, that's why I deleted extra values which is not required for us. Okay, now only that this table is coming in the thesis, not other things. It is a very simple things, or anybody can ask for a scatter plot. Okay, okay, you see here the scatter plot, aphid per plant and aphid per plant. You see here the linear relationship between two variables means aphid aphid, there is a relation means one. Now you can see here the maximum temperature with aphid, you can see here the negative or positive correlation means this is increasing, this side is positive correlation. You can see here the negative correlation, aphids and minimum temperature, negative correlation. You can see here the straight line like that, negative correlation, then straight line like that, positive correlation. Fill this dot is scattering here and there, not in a straight way or not in this negative way. You can say that there is no correlation. This is a scatter diagram, but this not give the actual degree of or actual magnitude of the correlation. That's why we are not going for this method, we are only going for the Pearson correlation coefficient. Okay, this is only coming. Okay, you see here the aphid, aphid is a negatively correlated with the minimum temperature. When minimum temperature is decreased, aphid will be increases, or when aphid will be increases, then minimum temperature will be decreases. Then this is non-significant. You can write result same like that. In aphids and morning relative humidity, there is a no correlation between, means when relative humidity not affect on aphid population, or not increase in aphid population, or not decrease in aphid population due to the morning relative humidity. You can see here the evening relative humidity. Evening relative humidity increases the aphid population and decreases the evening relative humidity. When evening relative humidity increases, aphid population decreases. This is negatively significantly correlated. Okay, and this is also rain also negative significant correlated. Means you can see here when rain is increases, means rain is increases, aphid population is decreases, and when aphid population is increased, rain is decreases. This thing is happening here. You can see how it's happened. When rain is come, then aphid may be splashes or flash from the plants and or wash from the plants, and they may be the population is less. That's why there is a negative correlation between rain and aphid per plants. This thing is comes in inference in our thesis. Okay, maybe this information is very useful for you, but this software may be or may not be in your Excel. That's why the you go over manual things. Manual things is same like that also, but we want to put only there the formulas. I hope this all information is very very useful for you, because I have seen nearly about 70 videos of correlation, but in that no any video I observed which is related to the agriculture. Okay, that's why I am taking the agriculture problem. This problem is related with the entomology section. Okay, I hope this all information is very very useful for you. And now time is 1 a.m. okay, this is very nice, a very fantastic college. Okay, when you are like my video, you can give like one like or subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.